Welcome to Resistance to Futile, the show where we smash up melons.
Today we're going to be using a few different weapons, ranging from a sledgehammer to a two-handed machete to visit death on these unsuspecting melons.
Today I'll be using a takedown recurve bow.
My tools are fruit destruction, or a sledgehammer and a two-handed machete.
I'll be using a double-headed axe and a two-handed machete.
And we also have a very special guest for us today.
Let's meet the team.
The bow I'll be using today is a takedown recurve bow weighing in at 1.1 kilograms. The materials used are beechwood and has a 35 pound 28 inch draw, center fire with the capability of shooting 75 centimeter steel arrows at a speed of 275 miles per hour.
Hello, I'm Chris Mann, and today I'm going to be using the Roughneck Sledgehammer, approximately 3 kilograms of pure power. I'm also going to be using the carbon steel two-handed machete supplied by Wessex Blades.
Today, I'll be using the Katana two-handed machete by Cold Steel. This is a 1055 carbon steel with a 2.88mm width, primarily for slashing. Can be also be used for thrust attacks. Modern intimidation with a classic samurai sword, 950 grams sheath, with a 500mm blade.
Hey, I'm Callum Connor and I'm the cameraman and equipment manager.
I'm here to make sure this lot don't hurt themselves.
What?
Weapons that I've got are actually quite new, so there's no real worry about them being in a poor state of repair. But as long as these kids are sensible, we shouldn't end up with any injuries.
Basic instructions on how to use the swords and the blades that we've got here in a way that's not going to create an injury. We've still got three fully packed medikits here, just in case.
And still only counts as one!
And what we're going to do is we're going to introduce them to using various appliances to affect death upon these melons. Now it's not like I'm going to let them loose with a load of sharp objects. We're going to have some fun, but we're going to do it safely. We're out in a nice field in the area of Wessex. And So, safety.
Without Scott, this project would have not been possible. He supplies us with almost every bit of equipment, from the medical kits, the bow, and the machetes. His techniques were very useful and it made the day a lot safer. And under his supervision, we were able to have a bit more fun and ask quite a lot of questions about.
The weapons that I brought along, these lads may not have been able to use them before. So what I had to do was introduce techniques that would allow them to use them safely. I know one of my roles was to actually make the equipment that mount the melons on so that we're able to use a very, very safe height so it wouldn't be hitting their shins. One of the main tricks I brought along is a fat load of cardboard. If you gaffer tape it together, it provides a very resilient back target for arrows. The last thing you want is an arrow skipping off of a piece of wood and ending up on someone else's property.
Straight off the bat, he'd used a bow before, his action was great, and he took very well to the more powerful bow. Indeed, his first practice shot, he hit a man the first time.
The bow I used was very light, had very good power, even with the 35 pound draw, he could still feel the tension of it. And with the centre fire, it just made it five times more accurate. I mean, when you let go, you see the speed, and it fires perfectly straight, and it just made it just five times more accurate.
Damn school!
Chris listened very well and he seemed to ask the right questions. He was able to pick up the machete and within a very short space of time was moving in the right direction. It seemed he had combat experience before.
The two-handed machete was very effective and clean. I underestimated it, therefore meaning I wasn't using it to optimum performance. Its sharpness and excellence has loads of grip, but the thing is, I wasn't swinging it hard enough to actually go through the melon.
Particularly like one shot that Chris had with the melon with the sledgehammer, his follow through was perfect and he really hit that sweet spot. That melon was toast. Mitchell took to the axe far better than most people would. He was able to swing it very well and he certainly enjoyed using it.
Whoa, that was close to me.
Now obviously, when using the weapons, I'm pretty sure everybody probably predicted the winner of the splatter shot right from the start, the second we mentioned the word sledgehammer. So without further ado, I give you the king of the splatter shot, the sledgehammer. End.
You can't touch this.
Okay, everyone ready?
Yep.
You can't touch this.
You
can't touch this.
No, I'm gonna load the battery.
You can't touch this.
Sir Yorick! Out damn skull!
You missed! I feel like a Minecraft damn skull!
36! 37! 38! 39!
I still only counts as one!
Can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living and you know. Can't touch this.
Ready?
Look at my eyes, man!
No, he's not.
Yeah.
Again.
Again.
God damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it.
That's cool.
Yo, I told you, you can't touch this. Why you standing there, man? You can't touch this.
Whoa, that was close to me.
Yeah.
And I'll be using the double-headed axe and the double-headed...
Yeah.
So today I'll be using the...
Find the melon, Molly.
The cats are in there.
Find the melon. Quick.
That was terrible.
It was.
With any injuries. Break it down. Stop. Hammer time.
Touch this. Look, man, you can't touch this. You better get hype, boy, because you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down.
This is less fun than hitting them.